in this constitution?
I think poverty and security are the two interlinked issues. You cannot have a secure and stable society if poverty has not been eliminated. During the war in Afghanistan, many women lost their husbands. They lost their brothers or fathers or any male member of the family. They were killed during war. And so the women are uneducated and they become the supporter of the family. If you are not educated, you become the supporter of your family, how can you feed the family? And therefore many women become victim of poverty. They had to send their children to go to work on the streets. Many of those children grew up in the streets or went to the madrasas and become talib. And in the rural Afghanistan, in the rural areas, there is a huge gap between living in the cities and living in the rural areas, because in the rural areas, less have been done in terms of trying to eliminate poverty or try to do something to reduce poverty. In the rural Afghanistan, women access to social services in terms of job creation, in terms of employment opportunity, is very, very low. And in fact, in many communities, there is no. Women are traditionally involved in agriculture. They're traditionally involved in housework. And that makes life for those women who are the supporter of the family and they lost their male member of the family, that makes it horrible for them.
Is there any way that the new constitution may able or somehow support them in the near future in terms of education?
There is a program. In the longer term, of course, education is the key because they need to be empowered capacity-wise. But in the short term, there are many programs that are foreseen in the rules and laws of Afghanistan. And that program, one of the programs is called National Solidarity Program. This program is implemented all over Afghanistan, in the rural Afghanistan as well, in the remote areas. And through this program, there are local shuras being established, local councils being established. Men and women are members of that local shuras. They decide on the priorities of their community, like one social priority of their community. If it's a school, if it's a woman project, if it's a health clinic or road or anything, that both men and women benefit from that. This is the only program that right now reaches the rural Afghanistan. And I hope that this program would also be expanded, although there are some concerns that in some part of the community, women are not member of this local council because of traditional reasons. But the projects that are implemented through this program, like school building, both men and women will benefit from that. Like road, if a road is being built or asphalted, both men and women will benefit from that. So this is the only program which is implemented nationally, national-wide program.